The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf.
Is we took some bench scale tests on our leach solution, our primary leach solution. We ran that through some ion exchange media, tried a couple different media, and it worked quite well. We were getting out of the heavy and light rare earths about 99.4 to 99.8% of the rare earths back into the resin.
Welcome back inside our Proactive newsroom, and joining me now is Bill Willoughby. He is the CEO of centurylithiumcorp. And Bill, great to see you again. How are you?
I'm good, Steve. Thanks for having me on. Appreciate it.
Yeah, so we've talked a lot about obviously what's going on at your Angel Island Lithium project in Nevada. We talked about, you know, your lithium able to help produce a battery for a company. And now you've come out with something to really add more value to the project. Is that a great way to describe it?
That's a very good way to describe it. Yes, we've had some very successful tests, some test work that was done back in August, but we finally got the results back, the assays. So reporting that today, and that's all around rare earths.
Yeah, that's exciting. A lot of talk about rare earths around the world these days. So tell me a little bit about what these test results are telling you, Bill.
Well, what we did is we took some bench scale tests on our leach solution, our primary leach solution. We ran that through some ion exchange media, tried a couple different media, and it worked quite well. We were getting out of the heavy and light rare earths about 99.4 to 99.8% of the rare earths back into the resin, and we were leaving the lithium that was in solution there. So all of that is excellent results. Points to the idea that we have a process that works, it's compatible with what we do, and it could be a nice add-on. I don't think it's going to surpass our other byproduct, which is sodium hydroxide, but it could be a good income generator, and certainly helps within the current framework of the U.S. and having a critical mineral supply.
Yeah, obviously, there's a lot of talk about critical minerals, as I mentioned, Bill. Talk to me a little bit about, you mentioned that extra revenue supply, about trying to get every, you know, last literally nickel and dime out of what you're taking out of the ground. And I think that's a key part of this, is the fact that you're every step along the way, you're de-risking the project and adding more value to it as you go.
Yeah, well, it's not like we're trying to squeeze everything out. Our primary focus is the lithium and making a good quality lithium carbonate. And there our process speaks very well to the fact that we can take our lithium claystone with fairly simple processes going from leaching through filtration, direct lithium extraction, and then finally making a lithium carbonate product. We make a very good product at the end of the day, and it all centers around our chloralkaline process. So we think that's a very good approach, and certainly fits well with this story today about an additional possible revenue from rare earth supply.
Yeah. Does this also give you the ability to potentially take some of that byproduct that you're talking about, the revenue from there, and then put it into the main source of what you're trying to do here? Does it help you sort of fund that as you go along?
We haven't gotten to the part of looking at the funding around it. But it certainly helps with, say, applications to the U.S. federal government in discussions with Department of Energy and Department of Defense, War, and so forth. So, it's a good side story. Our primary focus still is on lithium and what you can do with a lithium product and making sure we do a good product from mine to finished product. But, you know, we also have this supplemental income that we know will come from sodium hydroxide, caustic soda, and also now potentially these rare earths. So, and the real achievement today was, hey, our process works. It works for rare earths. And we were able to implement it successfully on the bench scale.
Well, we look forward to continuing to follow the story, Bill. It's going to be an exciting one for sure. Thanks so much for your time today. Appreciate it.
Yeah, thank you, Steve. Look forward to the next time being on.
All right. There's Bill Willoughby, the CEO of centurylithiumcorp.
The featured company is a paid client of Proactive Group Holdings, and this recording is disseminated by Proactive on its behalf. It is for informational purposes only and does not constitute investment advice, an offer, or a solicitation to buy or sell any securities. Viewers should conduct their own research and consult a qualified financial advisor before making investment decisions. The views expressed are those of the speaker and do not necessarily reflect those of Proactive Group Holdings, trading as Proactive Investors, or its affiliates. No responsibility is accepted for any loss arising from reliance on the information presented.